Trinity.
Your host for today, Max and
Keely from Leadership.
Please rise for the national anthem.
Holy Trinity, today we begin with a statement acknowledging the land on which we gather. We acknowledge that the land upon which we gather is the traditional territory of the Haudenosaunee and Anishinaabe Nations. We recognize that the Brand Holloway Norfolk Catholic District School Board and its schools have many ties to Six Nations of the Grand River and Mississaugas of the Credit First Nations, situated on the traditional land of the Haudenosaunee and Anishinaabe, within the Two Row Wampum and the One Dish, One Spoon Treaty areas. As a Catholic learning community and as treaty people ourselves, we strive to build the kingdom of God, where all people are treated with respect and dignity as we move forward as allies towards truth and reconciliation.
Good morning, Titans. Landon here to read your prayer. So this prayer is for today, December 19th. So this is the Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verses 5 to 25. So in the days of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah of the priestly division of Abijah. His wife was from the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. Both were righteous in the eyes of God, observing all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord blamelessly. But they had no child, because Elizabeth was barren, and both were advanced in years. Once he was serving as a priest in his division turned before God. According to the practice of the priestly service, he was chosen by lot to enter the sanctuary of the Lord to burn incense. Then when the whole assembly of the people was praying outside, at the hour of the incense offering, the angel of the Lord appeared to him, standing at the right of the altar of incense. Zechariah was troubled by what he saw, and fear came upon him. But the angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah, because your prayer has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear a son, and you shall name him John. And you will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth, for he will be great in the sight of the Lord. He will drink neither wine nor strong drink. He will be filled with the Holy Spirit even from his mother's womb, and he will turn many of the children of Israel to the Lord their God. He will go before him in spirit and power of Elijah, to turn the hearts of fathers towards children and the disobedient to the understanding of the righteous, to prepare a people fit for the Lord." Then Zechariah said to this angel, "How shall I know this? For I am an old man, and my wife is advanced in years." And the angel said to him in reply, "I am Gabriel, who stand before God. I was sent to speak to you and announce to you this good news. But now you will be speechless, unable to talk until the day these things take place, because you did not believe my words, which will be fulfilled at their proper time." So essentially, this is Zechariah and Elizabeth are talking about. These are the parents of John the Baptist. And what's interesting about this is that Advent is the season of waiting, and Chap's prayer, especially yesterday, was talking about this season of waiting and the idea of praying for things that we want. Now here, Zechariah has been given exactly what he wants, and he doesn't believe it, and so he's actually blinded until his son, John the Baptist, is actually born. So it just goes to show that sometimes we pray for things, sometimes we don't, and sometimes we even don't believe, but God still works through us no matter what. So I'd like to close with a quick Hail Mary. So in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. That's it for me, Titans. Have a blessed day. Now over to our hosts for announcements.
Thank you, Landon, for that awesome prayer. So now over to the cast specials today.
I thought I was doing them.
No, I am. I have the paper.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Anyways, now over to our cast specials today. So we have a turkey dinner, which includes turkey, mashed potatoes, gravy, veggies, stuffing, and cranberries for only $8.49. We have a holiday poutine for $6.99, cauliflower cheddar soup for $3.85, and grilled cheese.
Attention swim team members, registration for the AABHN swim meet on January 19th will take place over the Christmas break. If you are interested in swimming in a different event than you swam at our Guelph meet, please come down to guidance and discuss it with Ms. Freund or Ms. DeConnick O'Neill. If we do not hear from you before the Christmas break, we will register you in the same individual events as the Guelph meet. Please try to get in a couple of length swims over the Christmas break and have an excellent holiday. See you the first Monday back.
Merry Christmas. So just to clear up a bit of the air from yesterday, so tomorrow is Christmas sweater day, and that includes uniform, bottoms, and shoes. And Thursday is cozy day, and you are allowed to wear whatever shoes you would like. And that is the same for Friday as well, which is dress-up day. That's all for us, Titans. Over to student council.
Good morning, Titans. I'm Adi, and this is Jana, and we're here from student council for our last day of the Advent Giving Tree. None of you guys should be new to this, so I'm not going to explain how it works. We're going to grab a class, we're going to grab a prize, and that is going to be it for this. Johnny, you want to grab that?
We have here candy canes.
So we have candy canes for a class for Mr. Van Perry's class, room 242. The winners will be contacted after announcements, and hope you guys have a great day.